Hi students, for today's class we'll study perspective in art. Perspective is an art technique for creating an illusion of three dimension on a two-dimensional surface. It is what makes a painting seem to have form, distance and look real. The same rules of perspective apply to all subjects, whether it is landscape, seascape, still life, interior scene, portrait or figure painting. Before we start with the artwork, let us learn some linear perspective terms. Horizon line. Horizon line is an imaginary line where water or land seems to end and the sky begins. This line is always at the eye level, so everything you draw below that line will appear to be sitting on the ground, so it is called below eye level, and everything you draw above that line will appear to be floating or flying in space. This is called above eye level. Vanishing points are usually located on this line. Vanishing point is the place where parallel lines appear to come together in the distance. In this picture, you can see how the parallel lines recede and usually merge to create a single vanishing point on the horizon. A scene can have a limitless number of vanishing points. Linear perspective with just one vanishing point is called one-point perspective. So for your artwork, we'll be doing a landscape which has one-point perspective. So on your art book, keep the page vertical and first draw the line of horizon. Next, color the plane which is below eye level with green and above eye level, that is the sky, with blue. Mix white and blue if you want to give a little cloudy effect. Add lemon yellow or dark blue to give shades and tints of green. Next, somewhere in the center or off-center on the line of horizon, we'll mark the vanishing point. Now, with the help of a ruler, we'll draw a road which recedes towards the vanishing point. These lines are called perspective lines. Let us color the road using blue, red, and gray. Now, by making use of more perspective lines, we'll draw trees on either side. So, one perspective line below eye level and the other above eye level. Repeat the same on the other side. Now I'll draw lines which are parallel to the vertical side of the page, which will resemble trees. So taking the help of perspective lines, I will mark the top of the tree and the base. So the top will start here and end on this line. Repeat this till the vanishing point. Make sure the top and the bottom every time ends exactly on the perspective lines marked. Now let's complete the trees. Once the trees are done, mark two more perspective lines to mark a fence. Now with the help of perspective lines, draw vertical lines and complete the fence. Last, mark more two perspective lines to make grass. Our perspective drawing is ready. See that you keep your work neat. Hope you have enjoyed. Keep practicing. See you next class.